Hey guys, I am back reviewing another figure the gorgeous Jen Mitchell sent me for my birthday. Today we're looking at the Hasbro G.I. Joe Classified Series Shipwreck. Yes, Shipwreck was another classic G.I. Joe character brought to the Classifieds line. The character himself, Hector Delgado, a sailor turned Navy SEAL with the Joes. And with the Sunbow animation, when he was voiced, the voice actor decided to replicate Jack Nicholson because of his character, Billy Budsky from The Last Detail. Nicholson played this badass womanizing sailor. And essentially, Shipwreck is just that as well. He's a womanizer. He's a smartass. And yeah, he was a bit of a rogue among the Joes. So yeah, that's enough about the character. Let's have a look at the figure. First off, let's look at the box. Now, while it's not a windowed box, it's still collector friendly. You can still open it. You can still take the figure out and keep the box intact. So that's something. And the image on the front is pretty cool. You have a picture of Shipwreck with his different accessories and a really cool comic panel, dare I say, of the character there. Flip it to the side. Same image there. Flip it to the other side. There's the picture of Shipwreck, and flip it to the back. And it just shows the details about Shipwreck. But yeah, he comes with a secondary hairpiece, a parrot, a automatic pistol, what appears to be a double-barreled flintlock, an anchor, and some rope. You can see there he is without his hat on. It's weird that they made the hair completely removable and not just the hat. But I suppose that's just a choice with the figure. Yeah, he looks pretty cool, but I'm sure he looks cooler out of the box. So I'm going to pause the video here, and when we come back, we'll take a closer look at the figure. Don't go anywhere, I shall be right back. And we are back, and here is Shipwreck out of the packaging. So before we look at the accessories, let's look at the figure itself. So yeah, close look at the figure here, and focus in on the face sculpt. Really nice face sculpt. That's pretty cool. And flip it to the other side here. And you also get C's tattoos. That's pretty cool. There is a shark with a harpoon. I'll just zoom in there. There's a shark with a harpoon going through it. And on this side, he has this navy tattoo here. That's pretty cool. And he has the naval insignia patch there, and on that side, and it's kind of hidden by the holster belt, but he's also got this gold buckle with an anchor on it, and he has a holster on his hip, and he has a larger holster on the gun belt here, which also has a little sprue for the anchor that he comes with, and there's little pouches and stuff there as well. And going down, you can see he's wearing blue jeans. A wee bit kind of faded from being at sea, I suppose. And further down, you have his shoes. And again, nice detailing there. Just nice detailing on the laces. And even the stitching on the denim. It looks like solid denim. It looks cool. It's a really nice sculpted figure and nicely painted figure. And his expression is pretty cool. Again, the skin tone is perfect because Shipwreck is Hispanic, so they wanted to go with a more kind of exotic skin tone. Articulation-wise, he's fairly solid for articulation. He's got double hinge joints in the elbows. And he has good rotation in the shoulders and in the hands. Good rotation on the head. Nice bit of crunch there on the chest. And the torso is a bit tight. I don't want to go fiddling with it too much. He can do the Van Dams, but I don't want to feck up the holster or the belt. But they're still pretty solid. He does have a double hinge in the knee, so that can be contorted like that. Again, like with Outback, fairly solidly constructed figure. And yeah, I think Hasbro are kind of improving with each release of the Classified series. They're getting better with articulation and stuff. And as I said before, like with Outback, he's not too gummy and he's not too stiff. So it's a good solid figure. And I like this character. He's cool. He's nicely constructed. Nice paint work on the jeans. Nice kind of detailing with the tattoos and stuff. This is a really nicely constructed figure. As you can see there. Accessory wise, the first accessory he comes with, it is an alternative hairstyle slash hat. So let's pop it off there. And yeah, he's got a weird kind of head. It's even worse than Lady J's. The switchable hat with hair on Lady J's. She looked bald. This looks malformed. But yeah, just there's a sprue on the inside that fits perfectly. And there we go. He has got a sailor's hat on. Again, that looks pretty cool. Another accessory he comes with is this rope. I assume for maybe anchoring ships and stuff to a harbor or another boat. And yeah, you just simply put it on like so. And you put it on in a particular kind of direction as well. So you put it on like that, so that hole is facing upwards. You'll see why in a minute. But the cool thing is as well, is there's a little sprue on the rope for the anchor, which is here. This is the anchor he comes with. Now, there's two locations you can put the anchor on. You can put it onto his belt here, and it'll just hang like that. Or, as I said before, there's a wee sprue on the back here, and you can hand it off like so. So it can hand off the rope as well. The reason I said that it has to be facing this way is the little peg hole there. Because of this little guy. Yes, this is Shipwreck's pet parrot. As you can see there. And he's nicely detailed. Nice hint of green. And around the eyes and stuff. They've done a good job. And for some reason the poor parrot has a peg leg. But as I said before, there is a little sprue there. And you can pop it in to the leg like so. So his parrot can be perched up on his shoulder. It's weird. Shipwreck, he is supposed to be a kind of Navy SEAL and a sailor, but they've given him a pirate motif between the parrot and the first of two weapons he comes with. This is some kind of flintlock pistol, double barrel pistol, and it's more reminiscent of a pirate weapon more than a naval weapon. Like, at first I thought it was a flare gun, but it looks more like something out of Treasure Island. But there's really nice detailing on it. As you can see there, the accents of silver, there's kind of a pattern going through it. And on this side as well, and there's a little kind of rope there. And he can hold it. He can hold it very easy in his hand. So let's put it in and show you what it is like. Dun dun. So goes into that hand there, and he is ready to roll. He's ready to fuck anyone up who messes with him. Also, another thing about the parrot is, as well as being perched on a rope, you probably noticed there is a hole here in the hand as well. So if a Shipwreck wants to have his parrot perched on his hand, he can as well. Like so. So there's Polly, can be perched on his hand. I don't know the parrot's name, I need to double check. But for the meantime, I'll call her Polly. And the last item he comes with is another pistol. This is some kind of automatic pistol. But the cool thing is, there is kind of engraving on the side. It seems to be more maritime kind of engraving. Like an anchor. You can see there's an anchor on the handle. And that fits in nice and snug into this holster here. So pop it in there, and there's a hole as well, so the extended barrel, the compensator on the pistol can come through. But yeah, again, cool classified figure. Jen picked him up for me. He was on sale. And yeah, he's still badass for a figure that was on sale. And he's a worthy addition to the rest of my classified series. Speaking of, I'm going to compare this chap to some other classified figures in my series. So don't go anywhere. I shall be right back. And we are back, and there is Shipwreck in my alleyway. And let's compare him to another Joe who has a pet bird. Let's compare him to Spirit. And yeah, he scales up really well to Spirit. And let's try another Joe, a Marine. Let's try Gun-Ho. So there's Gun-Ho next to him. And yeah, scales up really well. That's interesting though. We got a muscly guy in a vest, a sailor, an Indian. Huh. Well, now it's just a fucking party, guys. It's fun to stay at the YMCA. It's fun to stay at the YMCA. They have everything. Yes, you can sail the seven seas. Yes, you can put your mind at ease.